Good morning all of you. So in yesterday's lecture we have discussed about sequencing of n job on two machines. Now today we'll discuss about processing or sequencing of n job through three machines. Now first we'll discuss about the various steps and then we'll proceed for the solution of particular problem in order to understand all these steps. So what is the step one? So there are three machines which are designated as machine A, B and C. So again, processing time for machine A, B and C that are given to us or that will be provided to us. That time may be in minutes or in hours or as per the requirements. Now if that time is available with us, then we have to examine the column for processing time on machine A, B and C. Now we have to check the condition. What is the condition? So we have to check the minimum processing time on machine A should be greater than or equal to maximum processing time on machine B. And second condition is minimum processing time on machine C should be greater than or equal to maximum processing time on machine B. If either one or both of the above condition holds good, if neither of condition holds good, then method fails. An optimal sequence has to be obtained by enumerating all the sequence. Then assume three machines A, B, C as two machines, that is small a and small b, such that their processing time is estimated as, that is processing time for small machine A is equal to processing time of machine, that is capital A, and machine capital B is, and the processing time for small machine B is the sum of processing time of machine capital B and machine designated by capital C. So this is the second step. So what is the third step? That is solve above sequencing problem similar to n job and two machine problem. So if the condition is satisfied, then we have to convert three machine problem into two machine problem. And once we consider once we convert this three machine problem into two machine problem, then in previous lecture we have seen how to solve sequencing of n job on two machine. So all these steps we have to recall in order to find the optimum sequence. So once the optimum sequence is achieved, then we have to find idle time and total processing time for machine A, B and C. So in previous lecture also we have seen how to find processing time, that is total processing time as well as idle time for respective machine. So that procedure once again we have to recall here. In order to understand all these steps, so let us proceed for one numerical. So this is the statement of the numerical. There are 5 jobs, each of which is to be processed through machine A, B and C in order ABC. The processing time in hours are given in table below. The table is also given to us. So determine an optimal sequence for 5 jobs and total elapsed time or total processing time. So this problem was asked for May 2018, December 2012, and this is the December 2018. So this is very important problem. Now how to solve this problem, that we will discuss. So it is the same problem. So the table is given to us. So there are job 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Processing time for machine A is 38754. Processing time for machine B is 45123. Again, processing time for machine C is 795610. Now, first of all, we have to observe the processing time for all these machines. That is our first step. So once we observe the processing time, then we have to check the condition. What is the condition? That is processing time on machine A should be greater than or equal to maximum processing time on B, or minimum processing time of machine C should be greater than or equal to maximum processing time on machine B. So if any one or both the conditions are satisfied, then we'll convert this three machine problem into two machine problem. Now let us check that condition. So what is the processing time on machine A? It is 38754. What is the minimum? Minimum is 3. Now what is the processing time for machine B? It is 45123. So what is the maximum value? Maximum is 5. Then processing time on machine C is 795610. So what is the minimum value? It is 5. So which condition is satisfied? That is minimum processing time on machine C is greater than or equal to maximum processing time on machine B. So that second condition is satisfied. So that's why we can convert this three machine problem into two machine problem. If both conditions satisfied or any one condition satisfied, then we can convert this three machine problem into two machine problem. If both conditions are not satisfied, then we cannot convert this three machine problem into two machine problem. For that we have other technique, but such problems we don't have. So if while solving the numerical in exam, always check the condition for the processing of n job on more than two machines. If condition is satisfied, then and then we'll convert the problem of three machine into two machine, or problem of four machine into two machine. If the condition is not satisfied, then just check this condition before solving any problem in exam. Now here second condition is satisfied as given in the steps. So that's why we'll convert this three machine problem into two machine problem. Now in order to convert this three machine problem into two machine problem, we have to consider machine small a and machine small b. And again, we have to write, we have to add processing time of machine capital A and machine capital B. And similarly, we have to consider machine small b. For that, we have to add the processing time of machine capital B and machine C. So accordingly, we'll write this. So these are the same steps that we have just discussed. Now here, this is machine small a and this is machine small b. So how we get this processing time? So this processing time is addition of processing time of machine A and B. And this is by addition of processing time of machine capital B and capital C. So by addition, we got these values. Now we have converted three machine problem into two machine problem. So this is n job we have, and we have two machines. Now three machine problem is converted into two machine. And since we have converted this problem from three machine to two machine, then we have to follow the steps that we have discussed in the previous lecture for sequencing of n job on two machines. So I will recall all that steps. So what is the first step for that problem? We have to observe the column 1 and 2. So here this is the column 1, this is the column 2, and we have to select the minimum value out of these values given in the column 1 and 2. So in column 1, what are the minimum value? It is 7. In column 2, what is the minimum value? It is 6. So here 6 is less than 7. So that's why we'll select this job 3 first. Again, this 6 is in second column, correct? So that's why we'll assign this job 3 last on machine A, and accordingly we'll score off this row. So that's why here I will write this job 3, and we have to score this row. After that, again we have to check the column 1 and column 2. So in column 1, what is the next minimum value? It is 7. Again there are 3 7. Here we have 1 7, again next 7, and here 1 7. In the next column, minimum value is 8, but 7 is minimum than 8. So that's why we'll select the values from column 1. But again, there is tie in the values of column 1. There are 3 7, that is, this is one value, then this is next value, then this is next value. So when there is tie in the value, then which value we should select? So in order to select that value, parallelly we have to observe this column. So with respect to this 7, here we have 11. With respect to this 7, here we have 8. With respect to this 7, here we have 13. So out of this, with respect to this 7, the check the values. Here we have 11, then 8 and 13. So it is the smallest out of these 3. So 8 is the smallest, correct? So that's why we have to select this job, or we have to select this value. And again, this value with respect to job 4. Again, this 7 is in the first column. That's why we have to assign this job first on machine 1. So that's why I will assign that job here. And as soon as we assign this job, then we have to score off this row. Then again, we have to check the next value. So next value is this one, 7. Here we have 11. Again, we have 7. Here we have 13. So 11 and 13, out of this, 11 is minimum. So that's why we have to select this value or this job. Again, this 7 is in the first column. That's why we have to assign this job 1 first on machine 1. So that's why I will assign that job here. Again, I have to score this row. The next 7 is here. Again, that is in the first column. Job is 5. So that's why I will assign that job here. So out of this 5 job, I have assigned job 4, 1, 5, 3. Now only one job is remaining and we have only one cell. So that's why directly we can write that value in this cell. And what is that job? It is the job 2. So directly I will that job 2. So accordingly, here we have the sequence, that is 4 1 5 2 3, that is 4 1 5 2 3. Now once we have obtained the sequence, then what is our next step? We have to find the idle time for machine A, then for machine B, then for machine C. We'll convert this 3 machine problem into 2 machine problem just to find the sequence. Once we find the sequence, then for finding the idle time for machine capital A, for machine capital B, and for machine capital C, then again we have to take into account, that is, actual processing time given in the numerical. So let us proceed for finding the idle time for respective machine and total processing time. So this is the table in which, when we assign all the jobs, then we have to score off all the jobs, that is shown here. Now how to find idle time for respective machine? So this is the actual data given in the numerical. For machine A, B, C, processing times are given and these are the jobs given. Now in order to find idle time, let us consider the sequence as discussed. So what is our sequence? It is 4, 1, 5, 2, 3. That is the sequence that we have defined. Now this is the column in which we have to write time in and time out for machine A. This is the column, here we have to write time in and time out for machine B. This is the column, here we have to write time in and time out for machine C. Again, we have to find idle time for machine A in this column, idle time for machine B in this column, idle time for machine C in this column. Now in previous lecture we have seen how to find this idle time for two machine problem. So same method we have to follow here. Now let us start with machine A. So for job 4, what is the processing time on machine A? It is 5 minute, correct? So we'll start with 0, that is time in is 0. So 0 plus 5, so time out is 5. Then for job 1, what is the processing time on machine A? It is 3 minute, correct? So time in is 5, so 5 plus this 3, so it is 8. So 5 plus 3 is 8, so time out is 8 minute. Now for job 5, what is the processing time on machine A? It is 4 hour. The time is given in hour in the statement. So that's why by mistake I have said minute, it is actually hour. So for job 5 it is 4 hour. So for job 5, time in is 8. So 8 plus 4, it is 12. Correct? Now for job 2, what is the processing time on machine A? It is 8 hour. So this is job 2. So time in is 12. So 12 plus 8, it is 20. Then for job 3, processing time on machine A is 7 hour. So time in is 20. So 20 plus 7, it is 27. So we have written the processing time, that is time in and time out, for all the job on machine A. Now we have to proceed for machine B. So for job 4, processing time on machine B is 2 hour, correct? And since we have to process this job 4 first on machine A, so that's why time out of machine A is time in for this job 4 on machine B. And this job 4 takes 2 hours to process on machine B. So that's why we add here 5 plus 2, it becomes 7. So time out for job 4 is 7, correct? Now for job 1, what is the processing time on machine B? It is 4 hour, correct? So but job 1, first we have to process on machine A and it will take 8 hours. So that's why time in for job 1 on machine B is 8 hour. So that's why here we have star mark. Now for job 1 on machine B, processing time is 4. So we'll add 8 plus 4, it becomes 12. So time out for job 1 on machine B is 12 hours. Now for job 5, what is the processing time on machine B? It is 3 hours, correct? Now again here the time in for job 5 is 12 and we have to add this 3. So 12 plus 3 is 15. So time out is 15. Then for job 2 processing time is 5 hours on machine B. Now since this job 2 takes 20 hours to process on machine A, so that's why we can take this job on machine B after 20 hours. So that's why time in is 20 hours. That's why here we have star mark and we have to add this 5. So accordingly 20 plus 5 is 25. So 25 is the timeout for job 2 on machine B. Then for job 3, what is the processing time on machine B? It is 1 hour. So for job 3, again it will take 27 hours to process on machine A. So that's why time in on machine B for job 3 is 27 hours. That's why here we have star mark and it will take 1 hour to process. So 27 plus 1, 28. So this is the time out for job 3 on machine B. Now we have to proceed for machine C. Again, time in for machine C is 7 because when processing of A and B is going on, at that time machine C is idle. It is idle for 7 hours. So that's why time in for machine C is 7. Again, for this job 4, what is the processing time on machine C? It is 6 hours, correct? So 7 plus 6, it becomes 13. So time out is 13. Now for job 1, what is the processing time on machine C? It is 7 hours. So time in is 13. 13 plus 7, it is 20. Then for the next job 5, what is the processing time on machine C? It is 10 hour. And the time in is 20. So and we have to add that 10 in 20. So 20 plus 10, 30. Then for job 2, what is the processing time on machine C? It is 9 hours. So time in is 30. So 30 plus 9, 39. For job 3, it is 5 hours. again time in is 39, so 39 plus this 5, that is 44. So we have written the processing time, that is time in and time out for machine A, B and C. After that we have to find the idle time for machine A, B and C. So total processing time considering machine A, B, C is 44 hours. So this is the total elapsed time, or this is the total processing time. Now how to find idle time for machine A, idle time for machine B and idle time for machine C. Now see here, initially for job 4, machine A takes 5 hours, but at that time machine B is idle for 5 hours. So that's why here I have written the idle time for machine B. Then similarly, when we process the job 4 on machine A, at that time C is also idle and it is idle for 7 hours. So that's why idle time is 7. So after that, machine A is continuously running, then 0 to up to 27 hours. But total processing time is 44. Correct? So that's why, what is the difference of this 44 and 27? So that difference is 17. And that is the idle time for this machine A. Now, similarly, when we process the job on machine B, then it continuously runs here. But here it is idle for 1 minute. So that is written here. Again, it is idle here for 5 minutes. That is written here. Again, the processing of all the job on machine B ends by 28 hours. And total processing time is 44 hours. So what is the difference of 44 and 28? So it is 16. So that is written. And again, it is idle for these 2 hours. So that is also written. So accordingly, that here 2 plus 16. So it is 18. So addition of all this we have to write in this column. Now for machine C, it is idle for 7 hours initially, then it is continuously running, but total processing time is 44, correct? And since it starts with 7 hours and works continuously for 44 hours, so that's why idle time is only 7 hours. Now finally we have to add all this processing time. So 0 plus this 17, so it is 17. Then 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 5, that is 11. 11 plus 18, 29. And 7 plus this 0, that is 7. So idle time for machine A is 17. For machine B is 29. And for machine C is 7. So in this way, we have obtained the idle time for all the machine. And we have obtained the total elapsed time or total processing time. So that is also given here. So total processing time is 44 hours, idle time for machine A is 17 hours, idle time for machine B is 29 hours, idle time for machine C is 7 hours. Now total idle time also we can add by addition of idle time of machine A, B, C. Now this is the problem of sequencing of n job on 3 machine. Now in the next lecture we will see how to sequence n job on more than 3 machines. So we will take more than 3 machine, so that may be 4 machine, that may be 5 machine, or in general m machine. So in the next lecture we'll discuss processing of n job on m machine. So today we'll stop here. Thank you.